Hello students, this is Mr. Idowu Olajide Taufik, your English language teacher. In today's lesson, I will teach you future tense. Let me say it again, future tense. Now, let us consider the following objectives. That means the objectives we are bound to achieve at the end of today's lesson. At the end of the lesson, the students will be able to define future tense. The students will be able to define future tense. Two, the students will be able to identify the types of future tense. The students will be able to identify the types of future tense. And lastly, the students will be able to use future tenses correctly in sentences. The students will be able to use future tenses correctly in sentences. Now, let us go for the definition of future tense. A future tense always indicates a time later than the present. In other words, it is used to denote an action that is expected to take place in the future. Now, students, think of this. When we talk about a future tense, it means the action has not taken place. The action is not on, but the action will occur in the nearest future. That is why we call it a future tense. The action is yet to be embarked upon. It's an action that has been suspended to the future. Now, we can also say that a future tense depicts an action that happens in the future or is likely to happen in the future. That means an action that is called a future action is likely to happen in the future. It may also express the speaker's attitude to a future action. We can form a future tense by including a lexical verb with a modal auxiliary verb. Let me say it very well. It is formed by using modal auxiliary verbs such as will, can, shall, may, might, etc. with a main or a lexical verb. That means for you to have a correct future tense, you have to introduce any modal auxiliary verb suitable, and then you join such a suitable modal auxiliary verb with a main or a lexical verb. Let us look at the following examples. One, there will be rain tomorrow. There will be rain tomorrow. I am visiting his house tomorrow. I am visiting his house tomorrow. I am going to do an internship in May. This time next month, I will be in London. He shall attend the lecture tomorrow, right? All these examples are future tense. They will occur in the nearest future. Now, let us go for the types of future tense. There are four basic types, namely one, simple future tense, future perfect tense, future continuous tense, and lastly, future perfect continuous tense, Now, in the next class, I'm going to teach you all the various types of tenses I mentioned earlier. That means we are going to consider each of them one after the other. Students, don't go away. Wait for your teacher, Mr. Du, Olajide Taufik, to come back for the next part of today's lesson. Thank you. God bless you. Students, you are welcome to the second part of today's lesson. The topic remains future tense. In the last class, I was able to define future tense, and I gave you the various types, such as simple future tense, future perfect tense, future continuous tense, and future perfect continuous tense. Let us start today's lesson with the simple future tense. The simple future tense denotes an action that will take place in the future. It expresses facts and certainty. Let me read that again. The simple future tense denotes an action that will take place in the future. It expresses facts and certainty. That means we can say that a simple future tense is used to express facts and certainty. Now, let us look at the various uses of simple future tense. 1. It is used to predict an event in the future. To predict an event in the future. For example, the uncle will come home tomorrow. The uncle will come home tomorrow. I shall meet you tomorrow. I shall meet you tomorrow. We shall begin the work on Monday. We shall begin the work on Monday. She will stay with us for another week. She will stay with us for another week. These examples express facts and certainty. The second one. It is used to express willingness. To express willingness. For example, his brother will carry the suitcase for you. His brother will carry the suitcase for you. We will tell you the address. We will tell you the address. I will type the letter. I will type the letter. He will write the letter on your behalf. He will write the letter on your behalf. These examples indicate willingness. Thirdly, it is used to give orders or instruction. It is used to give orders or instruction. For example, you will do what I asked you to do. You will do what I asked you to do. You will open the door for the principal. You will open the door for the principal. Let's go for the second type of future tense called future perfect tense. Future perfect tense. The future perfect tense depicts or denotes an action that will be finished at a particular time in the future. Let me say that again. It denotes an action that will be finished at a particular time in the future. The future perfect tense is formed using auxiliary verb with the verb to have with past participle verb. That is, any of the modal auxiliary verb together with have or has and the past participle verb. Let us look at the uses. 1. It is used to depict the duration of an action that starts before and continues up to another action or time. To depict the duration of an action that starts before and continues up to another action or time in the future. For example, at 5 p.m., I would have been out in the market for 3 days. At 5 p.m., I would have been out in the market for 3 hours. 2. To depict an action that will finish before a certain time in the future, but exactly when that happens is not known. For example, by 11 a.m., I would have completed my assignment. By 11 a.m., I would have completed my assignment. And lastly, it can be used for future completed action. For example, I should have written the book by tomorrow. They would have reached home by now. We will have been married when you come home again. Students, I am going to stop here to start the other part of today's lesson. Thank you. God bless you. students, you are welcome to the last part of today's lesson. The topic is future tense. Now let's go for the third type of future tense called future continuous tense. Future continuous tense. The future continuous tense depicts an action that is likely to happen in the future and continue for an expected length of time. Let me say it again. It denotes an action that is likely to happen in the future and continue for an expected length of time. It is formed using will with be with past participle. Let me say again, it is formed using will with be with past participle. Now, uses. It is used to, one, denote an action that will be in progress at some point in the future. To denote an action that will be in progress at some point in the future. E.g., she will be having dinner with us tomorrow. She will be having dinner with us tomorrow. I will be running the marathon next month. I will be running the marathon next month. He will be coming to school tomorrow. He will be coming to school tomorrow. Another one is, her husband will be getting angry with her. Her husband will be getting angry with her. When I return home in the evening, Blessing will be sitting in the garden. When I return home in the evening, Blessing will be sitting in the garden. Two, it is used for future planned action. For future planned action. E.g., the governor will be opening schools next week. The governor will be opening schools next week. They will be selling tickets for charity show next month. They will be selling tickets for charity show next month. We will be getting married this July. We'll be getting married this July. And the last type is future perfect continuous tense. Future perfect continuous tense. This tense depicts an action that will continue up until a point in the future. It denotes an action that will continue up until a point in the future. It is formed using will with have with been, that is B-E-E-N, with present participle. Let me say it again. It is formed using will with have with been with participle verb. Now let's see the uses. It is used to, one, depict the direction of an action that continues up to another point in the future. To denote the duration of an action that continues up to another point in the future. For example, by the time you arrive, I would have exercised for an hour. By the time you arrive, I would have exercised for an hour. When I meet you, I will have been dancing, so I will be tired. When I meet you, I would have been dancing, so I will be tired. By next July, she would have been working in the school for 5 years. By next July, she would have been working in the school for 5 years. And lastly, they will have been building the house for 5 years by next year. They will have been building the house for 5 years by next year. Students, that's going to be the end of today's lesson. But before I go, let me give you reference points. Please, you can consult Contemporary English Grammar by J.D. Modi. Two, The Pesetal English by S.M. Adebisi Adekoye. You can also Google www.mbaredonvu.com or www.enchantedlearning.com. For today's exercise, please provide the appropriate verb for the following sentences. One, Rahul has sold his bike. He dashed a car. So put the verb there. Two, this time tomorrow, we dash to Mumbai. 3. We will dash to London this summer. And lastly, I am afraid dash everything by the time they arrive. Thank you. God bless you.